Hello, everybody, and welcome back to my channel and my YouTube, my blog and my YouTube channel. I think this is the second video, and I think I'm going to call these videos or the series of videos Painter Step by Step, because that's what we're going to be doing is step by step. And if you remember in the last video, the first video that we did, my score, performance score was about 8,000 and something or another. 8,500 and something. So what I did is I closed the recording, which was going in the background, and re-ran my performance. And you can see it went up from that 8,000 to 12,000. And this is more like what it should be at for a computer as powerful as mine is. So I'm happy with this score. And you want to get that first really good big score, and then you don't have to do it anymore. You can just ignore running the report. Just remember that as you build your workspace, you're going to be adding stuff that will slow down some of your brushes. And it's probably best not to add as much stuff as I'm going to add. Because I will add a whole bunch of stuff, mainly for teaching purposes and that sort of thing. Okay, so once we've got this done, I'm going to close my Painter. Welcome window. You can get your welcome window again by going to Help and Welcome, and that will bring it up. I'm going to bring it up. A lot of people do not like to. They don't want it to just come on at startup. I do. I like having it come on because I'm going to use things like documents and setup and all of those kinds of things that are possible. I might look at a quick tutorial before I work or whatever. So I do let it open at startup and then I close it. Okay. Now, the first thing I want to do here is create a new workspace. I want a workspace that's specifically mine. So I don't want to do anything to Painter first. I want to create that new workspace. And we click on Windows, Workspace, New Workspace. Now, what pops up is this window that says Workspace Name. And then it says based on a particular workspace. So if I had three or four workspaces here, I could do it to the default workspace, factory defaults, whatever. And I'm just going to do it to it's based on the default workspace. And I'll call the workspace Skips 2023. And we'll save it. Now, once you save that workspace, let's give it a chance to go and save. Once the workspace is saved and you come back up here to workspace, you're going to see it and you're going to have a check next to it, meaning that the workspace is active. Now, the next thing I like to do is to create my layout. Okay. And so I want to create a layout that's specific to the way I like to work. And I like for everything to be over here on the right side so that I'm not crossing back and forth. I do have one or two things over here, but for the most part, everything is on the other side. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab colors and layers. Now that is already made up. We are currently in the default layout. Okay. And so certain things like pattern palette drawers have been made up, and right now we're in the palette drawer called colors and layers. So I'm going to come down here to this little layers and channel section. I'm going to click in the gray area and just drag that off. Now I've got this separated from that. I'm going to come up here and I'm going to click on those two little dashes there, and I'm going to click on rename. And I'm just going to name this Colors, because the layers are not going to be there. Okay, and I like for this to be over here somewhere, and we'll just stick it there for the time being. Now, layers and channels, I want to make into a palette drawer. So I'll click on those two lines again, click palette drawer, click on it again, rename, and we will call it layers / channels. And hit enter, and we now have another pattern, another palette drawer made. Now I'm going to come up here in this little dark bar here. I'm going to click on it and drag that command bar down. Then I'm going to get the next one and move it down. Okay, now the reason I did that is I want to reverse the way that works and put it over on the right side. So I'm going to take this and drag it over here and put it on the right side. Let it just click into place there. Now don't let it go to a blue line so that it set it up in the if you see the blue line, you'll lock it to the top. And I don't want to lock it. I just want to slide it over there and not get that blue line going. Then I want to take the next one, slide it in place, like that. And then I'm going to go to Edit, Preferences, and we're just going to go through these. So for the general workflow, all of this can stay the same, except that I want to auto-record scripts for one day. That's something I wouldn't recommend anybody doing, but I like to. Sometimes it, by saving a script that I've been, saving what I've been working on with the scripts, I can sometimes go back to something that I lose, and it's helpful. These pop-up messages, I'm going to leave all of that in play. Well, no, I'm not. Let's see, show dialog box when entering presentation mode. That I would want. I'm not going to show audio expressions because I know what to do there. Warn to save me about textures. I'll leave it in for the moment. Notify me when new captured tab may or may not. Yep, and warn me before converting selections. All that's good. I don't need to worry about this brush resizing. So we'll leave all of that the way it is now. I'm going to go to brush cursor, and I like for my brush to show as a, you know, as a circle or a little, or doing it this way, the icon, the circle or the oblong, the oval, whatever the brush tip looks like, stays that way. If you do any of the others, it's like it flips back and forth as you're painting, and I don't like that. So I just set that up like that. Now we go to interface. We have the dark gray thing, a gray theme, which I like. I'm going to leave it in pixels, and I'm going to click on this and give me a background color that's about twice as dark as it was. Brush icons, that's fine. We're right now in single document view, which is fine. I want to change the toolbox to single simple column, and the rest of this stays the same. Performance we have already done, and I leave it set to the way Painter decides to use it. Shapes, I leave that alone. Cloning, I want to close the source image. I want to open the source panel. I want to clear the canvas. I do not want to turn on tracing paper, and I do not want to switch to cloner brushes. And I'll leave this one set up to begin with this show edit source. And when we get to something like cloning, I'll turn it off at that point. Tablet, just leave as is, and connections don't have anything. So say, okay. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is something that I already have set up, but you won't, and that is I'm going to go to Preferences and to Customize Keys. And what I want to do is add my own personalized customized keys. So I'm going to click on the Open, and then I'm going to go to my custom painter stuff, and I'm going to go to custom keystrokes, and then I'm going to click on this 2020 because that's the latest one I have, and I'll click there and say open. Now you'll see my key set is in place, and I will say okay. All right, now let's continue building what we're looking at. I want to grab this now, this big thicker toolbox, and move it over like that. And actually, I think we need to, I've been going about 10 minutes now, that's too long for the videos. So let me stop here, and before I stop, I'm going to go to Windows, Layout, Save Layout. And the layout, remember, is called Skips 2023. And we say OK. Had I not saved it before? Well, that apparently was the first time I saved it. I thought I had saved it before, but I hadn't. So here is Skips 2023. Usually, if you save one and it's already there, it will tell you, do you want to overwrite it? So every time we save from now, we've got to go Skips 2023. And you want to do that before you close. Now, you also want to close Painter relatively frequently as you're doing this, because the workspace gets saved as you close. And so this workspace will be updated as I close Painter. So I'm just going to close Painter, and that will be the end of this second video. Talk to you later. Bye.